Once again, today I want to continue our discussion of some of the early church's anaphoras or Eucharistic prayers. Today I want to show you a Eucharistic prayer that came from Lower Egypt. It is found in a text called the Eucologion. The Eucologion was discovered in 1894, and it has a very detailed description of the liturgy. So this is the way it proceeded. There were readings from Scripture. There was a homily. There was a prayer after standing up from the homily, possibly the creed. There were general intercessions for the catechumens, for the people, for the sick, for good crops, for the bishop, for the church, and so on. Then there was a preface. That's what you see at the top of the screen. The holy, 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 the Eucharistic prayer, which here, unlike one of the other documents that we saw earlier this week, does include the words of institution from the Last Supper. This is my body. This is my blood. There is the breaking of the bread, the communion of the priest and the people, and a closing Thanksgiving prayer. So what you see on the screen here is the beginning of the preface. The Lord be with you and with thy spirit. Let us lift up our hearts. We lift them up unto the Lord. Let us give thanks unto the Lord. It is meet and right, or it is right and just. Then the next prayer is offered by the priest. It is the preface prayer. It concludes with that capital S in blue, singing the triumphal hymn, exclaiming, crying aloud, and saying. Then notice it says in red, as the choir sings, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of Sabaoth. Okay, and then there is the beginning of the Eucharistic prayer, this short little prayer. And with these blessed powers, O Master and Lover of mankind, we also cry aloud and say, holy and most holy art thou, and thine only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit, so on and so on. Then there are the words of institution. Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you for the remission of sins. After the same manner also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, drink ye all of it. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. And then there is something which is called the anamnesis, the recollection of the great things that God has done for us. There is also then, as you move down, it says, moreover, we offer unto thee this reasonable and bloodless service, and we beseech thee and we pray and implore thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here set forth. That, as we'll see, is known as the epiclesis. And then the Eucharistic prayer concludes with the same prayer that concludes our Eucharistic prayers now, the great amen, the great so be it, that is the communal proclamation of the church. So here again, we have an example of a very early Eucharistic prayer, but notice how much it kind of replicates the Eucharistic prayers that we pray even today.